Uncle Winkle, the show's about to start.
I'm coming as fast as I can.
Wave to the people.
All right, welcome to Moosetime. We are here today in the heart of Corvallis visiting one of the nation's most beautiful penitentiaries. They say actually they let their inmates walk around freely, and I think we are going to talk to them individually and kind of see what they have to say about the game this weekend. You know, it's a big rivalry game between the Ducks and the Beavers, as everybody knows. And it is Moosetime.
All right.
Take it easy. See? The enemy knows what's up. First enemy insight. We're going to see what happens. Excuse me, would you like to talk about the Civil War game this weekend?
I'm actually running really late to class.
Oregon State students act like they're actually students sometimes, too. Good luck, class.
I'm from Eugene.
You're from Eugene? Sorry, you a house divided? I think you'd be the most perfect person to talk to then.
No.
You're in Oregon State gear.
I know that.
Oh, God. House divided then? So who do you think's going to win this week's game?
Well, I'm definitely rooting for Oregon State.
Have you heard the comments made by Tyler Johnstone this week in the media?
No, not at all. I don't watch TV.
Well, that's probably good because they got pretty vulgar, I heard. Also, last question. If your boyfriend said, I'm going to break up with you if the Oregon State Beavers win, who would you cheer for to win?
Oregon State.
Oh my goodness. It's a serious rivalry, as we can see here. Well, thank you for talking to us. I appreciate it. Have a good day. Oh my God. Break up over a game. Jesus. Where's the love, Oregon State? Oh my goodness. Would you like to talk about the rivalry game this weekend?
I would not. Thank you, though.
Oh my. See? People are just so scared about talking about the rivalry game because they know what the outcome is going to be. And no one wants to talk because they don't want to admit the fact that Oregon is going to take it and there's just nothing else they can do about it. And it's horrible. But it's okay. You know, it's all in good fun. And you know, me and Mike, we're looking around this place. And the most amazing thing is the lack of guard towers. They literally just let the inmates around here just roam free. It's insanity. Look at this. See, look, just look around. I don't see a guard tower in sight. They're so trusting of their inmates. Man. I'd break out every chance I had if I went here. If this were Oregon and you had an Oregon State football player walking down 13th Avenue asking if people want to talk about the rivalry game, everybody would be like, yes, we want to. Oregon State's going down, flexing their muscles. Oregon State's just different. People just don't want to talk about it. I think they're kind of shying away from the subject, you know, because of all the past history. But who knows? But I think that's the reason. Well, what about, does Civil War mean anything to you?
Go Beavs!
There's one. There's some life from the Beavers, finally. Hey, go Ducks! There's no love for the Ducks here, that's for sure. Go Ducks! He just threw us the shotgun. He has no idea what's going on. God, a lot of support for the Ducks here. It's weird. I've said Go Ducks twice, and people just kind of gave me thumbs up and shaka, I guess. All right, we're going with it. Well, all right, that wraps it up for this week's Civil War episode of Moosetime. I thought there was going to be a lot more war and a little less civil side of things, but I just think that Oregon State has kind of lost the passion for the rivalry at this point. Everybody was way too nice. No one was into it. And I just don't know if that stadium's going to be full on Saturday because it just seems like they don't care. I don't understand why. It's a big rivalry and they just act like it's not. It's like it's almost an insult, but it's okay because our stadium looks cooler and I don't know what that football thing is supposed to be. Engineers don't make good artists here at Oregon State. No art. Not fine art at all. I don't even know what to say about it anymore. I'm pretty frustrated and frazzled because no one here cares about the game of football, and it's just, I'm going home to Eugene. I'm out.